Now let's cover the use of an automated external defibrillator, otherwise known as an AED, with an infant while CPR is already in progress. Now, I've either acquired the AED myself or someone's brought it on scene and it's now available. But there's a couple points of scene safety that need to be made prior to turning it on, and that is the baby laying in a puddle of water? This would maybe be most seen like if it was pulled out of a pool or a pond or lake and the water has now dripped into a bit of a pool or a puddle and we're kneeling in that water. With the conduction of the electricity may or may not happen, but we don't want to take any chances. So we would simply move the baby to drier ground, pat off the baby's chest and back so that the pads adhere to their skin, and that would be just fine. While we're talking about wetness and dampness, there's been some questions about a wet diaper and using an AED. A wet diaper is no problem. Remember, we're concerned about a puddle or a pool of water that the baby is laying in, not just damp clothing or dampness around the baby. While we're looking at the surface of the baby, let's talk about jewelry for a moment. There's been some concerns that the baby might be wearing a necklace or something, and it might cause problems when using an AED. That's not the case. Just simply move the necklace to the side, out of the way of the AED pad, and you should be just fine. Now, thirdly, though, is the combustible issue. Are there any combustible gases or flammable liquids or anything in the environment that if we had a spark, there would be problems? If the scene is safe, then you're ready to use the AED. So let's continue. The first thing we want to do with the AED when we have it is turn it on.
Remove clothing from person's chest.
Once we turn the AED on, we will follow the promptings. It's prompted us to remove the clothing so that we can actually access the points that are important for placing the pads on the baby.
Attach pads firmly to person's chest as shown.
As we turn the AED over, it has two sets of pads, the pediatric size pads and the adult size pads. In this case, obviously, we want to use the pediatric size pads.
Plug-in connector.
When we open up the pads, you'll see in most cases a diagram that shows you where to place the pads. So this very first one we'll take off and we'll place it as the diagram shows, right on the center of the chest. Make sure that it's stuck well and not peeling up, as that can affect the way the actual pad works. Now we take the second pad off, carefully rolling the baby up onto its side, protecting its head and neck. We place it in the appropriate location between the shoulder blades on the center of the back of the baby and roll them back onto their back. Now, the AED is prompting insert electrodes or connect the wires. So we do that. We plug it in and we follow the prompts. It's at this point that we wait for the AED to actually charge and then encourage us to push the flashing button to rescue. Making sure we're not touching the patient, it's prompting us to push the flashing button, and so we do.
Push the shock button. Shock delivered.
As soon as we've delivered the shock, it's vital to remember that per current research and guidelines, we don't want to delay the very first compression following the shock. We want to minimize that time gap, so that we're getting the pulse pressures back up as soon as we can and getting good circulation of oxygenated blood as fast as we can. So now we begin with our 30 compressions followed by 2 rescue breaths. We're following the same guidelines that we follow with the CPR, which is compressing a third of the depth of the chest or approximately 1 to 1.5 inches deep. And we're going to compress at a rate of at least 100 compressions per minute, no more than 120 compressions per minute, which is about 2 a second. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8, 9 and 10, 11 and 12 and 13 and 14 and 15, all the way up to 30 compressions. We take our mask, we put our one-way valve shield over the baby's mouth and nose and deliver 2 rescue breaths. We deliver our 2 rescue breaths, and then we go back into our chest compressions for 30 more times. Now, note here that I'm pressing over the pad. At no point would I want to remove the pads from the back or the chest of the baby. We're going to leave everything intact and do our CPR right over it. You will be interrupted potentially from time to time by the AED. Simply follow the prompts and continue your protocol until EMS arrives, someone equally trained or higher comes to relieve you, or the baby actually regains consciousness. But if the baby does regain consciousness and starts to breathe on their own, though we may stop doing CPR at that time, we would leave the AED intact and allow it to monitor the patient until EMS arrives and takes over.